Are you thinking about buying a short sale? I have five big things I need to discuss with you about buying a short sale that you don't want to miss. Talk. And this episode, we're going to dive into the five tips that you need to know if you're considering buying a short sale property. Let's start off with what is a short sale. A short sale in real estate is when the net proceeds from selling the property will fall short of the debt secured by the lien against the property, which means that the owner actually owes more than the property is worth. So let's go ahead and talk about the five tips in purchasing a short sale that you need to be aware of. Tip number one is there's no guarantee. That's right, there's no guarantee. Even though you and the seller may have a fully executed contract, there's no guarantee that this will come to the closing table. Why? Because one, the lender has to approve the short sale, and there's no guarantee with that. Two, the proceeds for the foreclosure for the particular home that you're interested in buying may be further along than you think, and it end up going through the foreclosure process. Or three, the seller may have a temporary financial problem where they can find finances to help catch them up on their mortgage and not move on with the short sale. All right, you guys, tip number two. Tip number two is price. Now, with my experience, many people come to me and want to put an offer in on a short sale, and they want to put an offer in really, really, really low, thinking that the seller is desperate and they would take their offer. That's not the case. All right, so let's think about this just a little bit. The price is usually right at market value. In some cases, it can be a little bit higher or a little bit lower if they're really trying to get as many offers really quickly and submit it. But in most cases, it's priced right at market value. Not only that, but the bank is usually going to do something that's called a BPO, which is a broker price opinion, order an appraisal, so they know what the value of the home is. And usually, in most cases, a bank would accept a short sale offer if the buyer who's purchasing the property submits an offer anywhere between 8 to 10% of the value that it comes back for the market of that home. So they won't take an offer that's extremely low. And in some cases, depending on the representative for the bank, sometimes they could be really, really firm and want to get as close to the value of the home as possible. So I want you guys to take that in consideration, because you can submit an offer and the bank come back and say, no, we don't want to accept that offer. And then as a buyer, you have to start all over again searching for a home. Because you put in an offer that's too low and missed the opportunity of putting offers in other homes that you might have been interested in. So if you are interested in a home, show how serious you are to the bank and the seller by offering an offer that is anywhere between 8 to 10%. And from there, most likely you'll get a chance to receive an acceptable offer. But that varies, again, from bank to bank, lender to lender. All right. Tip three is the time frame of the short sale. You need to be aware that short sales are not the typical type of closing that can happen anywhere between 21 to 45 days. Short sales can typically take anywhere between 3 to 6 months, sometimes a year or even shorter. So as a buyer, you have to be aware that it's going to be a lengthy process, and you need to be patient and open for communication along the way. Tip number four, As your real estate agent, I want to know, what is the status of the short sale? Is the short sale already approved, or are we pending approval? We also want to know, has the listing agent and the seller put together their proposal to present to the lender once they have an executed contract? And I want to know as well, what is the final date if one is already set for execution of the foreclosure? And has the seller secured an attorney to help delay the foreclosure so the short sale has enough time to work itself through? Those are the things that we need to know when we're talking about the status of a short sale. Tip number five, you guys, is escrow. Let's talk about the money. So we know with a typical sell that you go anywhere between 1 to possibly 3% down for an escrow. With short sales, my goal is to put down as little as possible as a buyer's agent until the short sale has been approved. And then we will write in the contract that we will make a second escrow deposit of a larger amount once the bank has approved the short sale. Another thing is that we need to know is that even though you and the seller has agreed on the purchase price, it does not mean that the bank is going to accept that purchase price. As a buyer, you have to understand that we need to have a loan officer that is ready to move swiftly and close within 30 days, and that you have enough money to pay for the home in the event that the bank comes back asking for a larger amount for the purchase of the home. So those are things that we would talk about and work through as your real estate agent. So these are my five important tips that you need to know before considering purchasing a short sale. If you do not have a realtor and you would like to talk about these things more in depth, I would love to help you. I service both Miami, Broward, and Palm Beach County. And I am available to help you by email, phone, text. You can find me anywhere. And if this is content that you like to see on a continuous basis, I'm going to actually go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Go ahead and hit the like button. And go ahead and leave me a comment below. I promise you I will answer them all. Until the next video, be blessed and have an awesome and an amazing day. Bye-bye.